Dear student, in power transmission, the last part is called compound gear drive, which already we have learned in belt drive. You know what is compound belt drive. Same way here also, two transmission, see N1 and N2. Now N1 and N2 and 3 are on the same shaft. From here the drive will go to the other one. So from there it will go to the follower. Now this is NA. Now transmission ratio of the first, speed of the first gear and the last gear is important. In between there is an arrangement called compound gear drive. Same way, see, in the last class also we have seen N1 Z1 is equal to N2 Z2, equation 1. Now that is the relationship here. Next one is N3 to N4. Sorry, N3 Z3 is equal to N4 Z4. Equate together. What happens? N1 by N2, Z2 by Z1. Sorry, next one. N3 by N4 is equal to Z2 by Z1 into Z4 by Z3. Now here what happens is N2 is equal to N3 because both on same shaft. N2 is equal to N3. The speed of these two gears are same. Why? Because both are mounted on the same shaft. That is why here what happens is gets cancelled. N1 by N4, which is equal to NA, the speed of the last first gear, speed of the last driven gear, the relationship is, which is totally, it is called as I. Now this is I1, I2 is equal to product of teeth of driver, driven, Z2 into Z4. Divided by Z1 into Z3, which is nothing but product of driven, dia of driven, divided by product of dia of driver. Always even number represents the driven. And odd numbers are representing the driver. So in this, 1 and 3 are drivers, 2 and 4 are driven. So straight away with this particular formula, N1 by N4, we can calculate the transmission ratio between the first gear and the last gear. First gear is called as NA, last gear is called as NE. So NA by NE is equal to N1 by N4 is equal to Z2 into Z4 divided by Z1 into Z3. Here, this I can be calculated by this one. See, product of two ratios, I1 and I2. I1, this is the relationship which is called I1. This is the relationship to I2. So, totally if you want I1 into I2. By that method also you can calculate the transmission ratio. So, here when you want more changes in the speed, you have to go for this type of arrangement called as compound gear drive. Now related assignments are there. Try it out. Try all those assignments. And it, now one more thing, very important thing which I want to tell you is, see, recently when I uploaded these videos in the channel, one of my friend saw it and he telephoned me that NSQF, you are in the NSQF 5 level, is it not? In that, syllabus is changed. I was shocked. But it is the truth. Actually, syllabus is changed. Then later on in the office, when it is clarified, it was not parted to me. That knowledge was not given to me. Slightest changes are there in our syllabus. So that's why what I have done is, today I uploaded a new syllabus in which certain things are eliminated. like things like power transmission, statistics, graph, all these things are eliminated. But if you are written, see, knowledge is never, it's a loss. I can't say that the knowledge is lost. So whatever you gain, it will be there with you forever, no problem. But examination point of view is different. There where we have to pass. So if you have to pass means you have to work on it and you should be thorough in that. So that is why the new syllabus HISM, in that 4 chapters are pending. So one after another I will do. Now this you let it be, write the notes, this definitely I am going to evaluate. Notes you have to write and you have to see, this is very important for your future life. When you tomorrow, when you become an operator, you must know the relationship between the driver and driven. What speed you want. So if you, somebody tells you set the speed, you must be able to be positioned to set the speed. So if you want to set the speed, what you must know? Exactly what the speed I want to get in the dead work end. That means motor will be steady. You all know that motor will be same. It will be rotating in the same speed. But in the shaft end, what the speed necessary? Depending upon the cutting speed, you can calculate the speed which you want. Then according to that, you can set that speed. Or you can change the diameter. So all this knowledge you will get from this power transmission chapter. So that is why there is nothing, no loss as such. So that's why you write and keep, and definitely I am going to sign on the notes. So after that, next video onwards, I am going to teach you the remaining 4 chapters. In this, 4 things are pending, like which I will discuss. When you after come to the institute, I will discuss about it. What is pending? In my point of view, the pending one is, pending subjects are heat treatment and costing and estimating, profit and loss, cost and estimation, profit and loss. All 3 chapters are pending, which in 3 videos I'll upload it, and I'll write the notes first, then I'll upload the notes, then I'll send the video. And now for the time being, you just go through this, go through the syllabus. And one more thing, the notes also, textbook also I uploaded. All of you download that textbook and you can see exactly sums also. Now printing and all not necessary, because only last hiccup is pending, is it not? Last test. So that's why just to pass through, you need not again go to the textbook I have uploaded. Download that and just go through the textbook, you will understand. Then notes also I will send. Next videos, before next video, I will send the notes of the next chapter. Probably I am going to teach heat treatment. Okay, thank you very much.